real smooth ride over a plowed field on triangle-shaped tires.
Last episode, Joe and I looked around this old property at several old cars and trucks. We checked them out and kind of talked with the owner which ones he was wanting to get rid of. And so now we've made a list, and today's the day we're going to be pulling them out of the woods.
Crazy stuff that you guys have probably seen worse.
Yeah.
When you get older, you get the more sensitive your skin is.
And Gordon,
Gordon, our buddy, has paper skin.
Yep.
His name is Steve.
Yep.
He's going to be watching this too.
So. Yep. Put a pry bar on top of the screws. There you go.
I am now the king of hub pulling, Tim.
All right. It's like those senior wells in high school.
I do not know that.
I, Tim, will my ability to pop front brake drums to Joe. So, like, if anybody in the graduating senior class has some special skill or talent that they're known for,
yeah,
when they graduate, they leave. And so they will it to one of the underclassmen.
Gotcha.
Senior wills.
Looks like that back tire rolled.
Yeah, they both backs rolled. I bought a thread file. Joe's got the Unilug spare tire happening here.
Unilug by Joe.
Unilug.
By Mr. Goodhammer.
by Mr. Goodhammer.
Have you gotten us t-shirts and hats yet that we need?
I have not.
You should. Mr. Goodhammer, Mr. Goodpliers.
Oh, yeah.
Those are Jeep wheels, and so that four-wheel drive, it'll fit the rear, but not so well the front. Ready.
The one below it. Yeah.
Picturing a form of snatch squat.
Gotcha. Yeah, so I'm gonna drive around.
Let me get the window down. It's where we can drag it.
Only held air for a bit.
A bit.
Do we have four lugs?
We do not.
Are those two plated?
These two on this side are. I don't know. Matters. Huge amount, but it'd be nice to load them.
Yeah. Where was the cap?
Can you see it in your mirror? I think it'll clear. That's probably good.
What we could do is pull off of that tree.
Uh-huh.
And pull forward and have it pulled up here. Kind of that way you can swing it.
Yeah.
I can't air up the I can air up the front.
Because you know it sets there, so I'll go. Are you, yep.
I don't want to jerk on it.
Yeah, I don't want to break that strap. I would imagine those rears are probably, yeah. You know, if you want to.
Can we pop them in?
Probably need to.
Okay.
Torch them. Torch
them?
If I.
Come with the regular.
Let's try with the regular.
Regular. You can just leave this, though.
Oh, I see.
You know, we could I should have pulled back more. We could put it where it's beyond that knob. Yep.
bummer.
Bummer.
Did we break it at the knot?
Yes, we did.
Yep. Usually knots have
that's what Gordon said. Oh, wow, it broke it at 50 end to end that end?
It broke it at both?
Oh, well. I think those rears are locked.
Yep, we broke it at both ends. There's two pieces of strap.
That's amazing.
Okay. What do you say we pull it? We are out of Wasoma.
Should I turn the regulators in? Should I turn the regulators in, or do you want to take it up there and light it up there and work the regulators?
You and those glasses reminds me of the sheriff from Oh Brother Where Art Thou.
Which isn't it patented off of that Paul Newman movie?
I think Ford beat everybody with the LTD.
That was 66, right?
I think 65 was the LTD. Plymouth was a VIP. That wasn't until 66. I think Chevy did a quick crash program and they were second.
Oh. Not this one. The one from the dealer. car is
second or third drawer down. Yeah. Big drawer.
Bigger or smaller? Probably bigger.
Sure, yeah.
I ended up getting a big one.
Glass belt.
Won't need the steering wheel puller for that because it wiggles.
I can use the other pry bar.
The steering wheel we can pop off without the puller because it wiggles. Okay. Real smooth ride over a plowed field on triangle-shaped tires.
Got some other wheels that I think are 4.5 that might be aluminum just for rollers if you want them for now. I don't know if I have them. I don't remember why I have them, but I do have them.
If the donut spare was in the back of that Grand Prix, it would work.
Is it?
The red Grand Prix, front wheel drive.
That's the one I was going to ask you about. Or do you have any interest in that thing?
Possibly.
Because I don't have any need for it.
Okay.
I did tell you that that guy that farms here took some few parts off of it.
Really?
Yeah.
Those originals were probably so skinny.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Nuts will barely grab. You want to grab me the gun?
Take the hood off the Cutlass and sled it. I mean, the truck doesn't weigh anything.
No engine on it.
The tyranny of the tie rods. You know what I've also done in the past? It's crazy, but it works. Is take an old gas tank and chain it around the axle. Oh, it's tire weight, I bet. Quarter ounce.
Make sure to get a close up on this house paint. They put it on here with a brush.
Oh, yeah.
You can see the brush marks on it.
House paint patina's down so nice.
Yeah.
If nothing else, skid it on the tires. Hundred yards, diesel versus incomplete truck.
Oh yeah, that's the way those Fords are. Torch. That's an Exxon tire.
Isn't that crazy? Torch.
I didn't have an idea for these tie rods.
And just like magic, truck now has a front clip, and Joe and I are covered in barn dust.
Go ahead. Hold on. You were right about the wheel. How did you know? Nice and easy, I don't want to scratch it. Okay. Go ahead. What's that?
Bumper.
Yeah, we can do that.
Want to throw it in or do you want to throw it through the windshield?
No, we can go across the hood. Like it was made to be there.
Now, we need a video here of you sitting on the roof steering and steering it.
All right.
if you can, make sure to miss 56s, because we can always pull this ahead and cut down the tree.
Okay.
I guess we can do the pull the 56s ahead.
So here's the lineup. 63 Bel Air, four door post, 1980, cutlass chrome, 1955 International, L110, half ton pickup, 1973 Chevrolet Caprice, four door post, 1965 Comet four-door, and the 1968 69 Ford Torino four-door. The Ford should run if tinkered on. Comet, he didn't know anything about, so it's a big question mark. Caprice, no engine, rusty body, all three of those strictly part scars. International, got good promise to see the road again. Cutlass, probably just a frame and steering column, maybe a rear bumper. I'll pick on that one a while. There's probably more there than it looks. 63, pretty neat car. His aunt bought that new. She drove every day from Lenzburg to Wichita working at Wesley Hospital, and just bought a 77, traded this one in, nothing wrong with it. Parked this car rather than trading it in. Chance it could run, who knows?
Because I have a nice ship.
They would be, yeah. We lost a spare tire out of the 73. Trunk just plumb rotted out, and there she landed.